So we've got a great program of, as I say, lots of intermediate tributes to an artist who made that kind of art a big part of our cultural conversation today. And we'll start with a reading from Lafcadio Cass. So please welcome him to the stage.
Hi, everyone. So the lovely and wonderful Ann Carson and the lovable Bob Curry wrote a poem for tonight, but they can't be here. And I thought it would be a great idea if we did this together. The poem is based on the alphabet. So when I go like this, when I point up, we'll just read off the letters and I'll read the little bits afterwards. Does that sound like a good idea? Okay. A is for Amelia and Earhart and air itself.
B
is for books on the stairs.
C
is for colloquial sayings cut into strips and listened to backwards.
D
is for dummies and Dutch astronauts.
E
is for excited skeleton and ebb and flow, calm or furious.
F
is for flying everywhere, forest, fir beach, or maple, or just for Fenway, or for nothing more needed than friendship.
G
is for glottal gluing and the way it hums, and Guantanamo. Is for having the Hudson half a block away.
I
is for ice skates into ice block.
K
is for Japanese gardens looking good 1,000 years from now.
K
is for keys bent from the dream before.
L
is for luring under of language, Lola Bell and always for Lou.
M
is for meeting up for breakfast, a play, a walk, dinner, a show, a talk. And for Muhammad.
M
is for neon bow. Is for the oldest man on the reservation.
He
is for pre-flood civilization.
He
is for questions quick.
R
is for returning to Tai Chi with Master Ren, the transcendental marauder.
S
is for sleep dogs, sea lions who have been trained as directors of photography, sound of a clock being wound in 1940.
T
is for tape hiss and fortuitous troubles. Is for unsubmissive urgent urchin.
E
is for vegetarians, four simple rules. Don't eat anything with a face, don't eat anything with sexual urges, etc., etc. Is for walking to the North Pole, only slightly more daunting than walking little Will.
X
is for let X equal X.
Y
is for you can wake up now, we're almost done. Is for zipped up, proper, and over. Thank you.
I the motel. Now by the residents of Puppet Motel, they're more than a little spooky, and most of them are mean. They're running the numbers, they're playing cops and robbers. Down the dungeons, inside their machines. Dimensional dreams. The mind's out on bail now, and real's only what it seems. And all the puppets in this digital jail, they're running around in a frenzy in search of the Holy Grail. They're having virtual sex. Food. No wonder all those puppets are in such a lousy mood. Yeah. Come on. You know about it. You've been there. So if you think we live in a modern world where everything is clean and swell, just take a walk on the wild side, downtown, by the Puppet Motel. Take a whiff, burning plastic. I drink a cup of coffee, I try to revive. I'm barely alive. My nerves are shot. I feel like hell. I guess it's time to check in to the Puppet Motel. Boot up. Good afternoon. Good evening.
Well, I was down at the Zigzag. That's the Zigzag Bar and Grill. 63 cents. Now 50 years ago that was 62 cents, so with that kind of luck it'll be the year 3888 before we make a buck. But hey girls,
driving and it's dark and it's raining and you're on the edge of the city and you've been driving all night and you took a turn back there but you're not really sure it was the right turn. you took the turn anyway. You just kept going in that direction, and somehow it all looks sort of familiar. So you just keep driving. Hello. Excuse me. Can you tell me where I am? You've been on this road before. You can read the signs. You can feel your way. You can do this in your sleep. you've got x-ray eyes. You know how to sing. You're a diplomat. You've got it all. Look, you forgot to take your shirt. And there's your books. And there's your pen. Sitting on the table.
Couldn't find you. I wanted you, and I was looking for you all day. But I couldn't find you. You're walking, and you don't always realize it. You're walking. You're walking, and you don't always realize it.
But I couldn't find you.
And falling.
I
the same time. There were the wires for empathy that we loved beyond all the others. Of all the wires, it was the wires. There were the wires for empathy that we loved beyond all. Streaming in.
good evening. Good evening, Laurie. I have to say, this is really an amazing evening, and I just want to let you know, you never forget your first, and I was the first. Whether it was good or bad, you never forget your first. Just saying. But I also just wanted to say a couple of words for Laurie, because she is so amazing. And I remember first seeing her, hearing her, and she was in the same realm for me as Brian Eno, Robert Fripp, Peter Gabriel, later Talking Heads, earlier Klaus Nomi. You know, I lived in the 70s, but I worked downtown. Just to let you know. And so thank you, Laurie, for all that you have inspired me to do over the years, introducing me to a lot of electronics and new ideas. And so this is the picture.
Look out! They're watching out! Watch out!
Hawkins. Congratulations, Laurie.
Play about birds called The Birds. And it's a short story from before the world began, from a time when there was no earth, no land, only air and birds everywhere. But the thing was, there was no place to land because there was no land. So they just circled around and around because this was before the world began. And the sound was deafening. Songbirds were everywhere. Billions and billions and billions of birds. And one of these birds was a lark. And one day her father died. And this was a really big problem, because what should they do with the body? There was no place to put the body because there was no earth. And finally, the lark had a solution. she decided to bury her father in the back of her own head. And this was the beginning of memory. Because before this, no one could remember a thing. They were just constantly flying in circles. Constantly flying in huge circles.
His bones are coral made. Those are pearls that were his eyes. Nothing of him doth fade. But that suffers a sea change into something rich and strange. And I, alone, am left to tell the tale. Call me Ishmael. Get this letter, thinking of you, love and kisses, blue Pacific.
Can deal with the problem, because half the problem is seeing the problem, and only an expert can deal with the problem. Only an expert can deal with the problem. So if there's no expert dealing with the problem, it's really actually twice the problem, because only an expert can deal with the problem. Only an expert can deal with the problem. Solutions. We like solutions to problems. And there's so many companies that offer solutions. Companies toys with names like the pet solution, the hair solution, the debt solution, the immigrant solution, the sushi solution. Companies with experts to deal with the problem. Only an expert can see there's a problem, and only an expert can deal with a problem, and only an expert can deal with a problem. Cause only an expert can deal with the problem, and only an expert can deal with the problem, and only an expert can deal with the problem. You don't have a problem. But you really want to be on the show. So you need a problem. So you invent a problem. But if you're not an expert in dealing with problems, you're probably not going to make up a very plausible problem. You're probably going to get nailed. You're going to get exposed. You're going to have to bend down, apologize, and beg for the country's forgiveness. Cause only an expert can deal with the problem, and only an expert can deal with the problem, and only an expert can deal with the
problem.
all the animal species that have disappeared off the face of the earth, called all the disappeared animal life forms of the world. Now the list is really impressive, and it included all the dates and territories where the animals were last seen, or wherever the last fossil was unearthed. Now, as you probably know, 99.9% of all the species who ever lived are now extinct. So, this is a very long list, including massive numbers of civets, big subsets of spotted lizards, every last mastodon, the short-faced bear, the saber-tooths, 15 chapters on sloths, and one whole chapter on the one-eared dinosaur.
Thank you.
that I really love the stars is that we cannot hurt them. We can't burn. We can't melt them or make them overflow. We can't flood them or blow them up.
Hello. Yeah.
Star? Hi, it's Cheryl.
Oh, hey, Cheryl, yeah. I'm good, how are you? Pretty decent. The zipper does fall down sometimes, but it's pretty good. It's okay.
Okay, good.
Yeah.
That pedal you were playing before was so amazing.
Oh, thanks so much, yeah.
What was that?
It's a voice live play. It's a TC Helicon pedal, yeah.
You were amazing.
Oh, thank you. Thanks, Sharon. That's really nice. Thank you.
Efficient. Hey, Star,
yeah.
did you see that guy over on stage right in the back that was waving?
No.
At us. I didn't know if he knew you or...
No. I thought he knew you.
Oh no. He just keeps asking us to play another song.
Okay. No, I thought he knew you. I didn't think he was waving at me.
You know what I always wanted to ask you, Star?
Yeah.
When you were a kid, did you ever play that game Horse? You know, where like...
Oh, no, new call. But is it a
we got disconnected Cheryl? Somehow. It's me. Yeah, sorry.
Okay.
I remember that game Horse where, you know, the top half was the rider and then it was more sophisticated and then the bottom part was the galloping wild legs. I just was wondering if you ever played that.
No, I never played that. And, you know, I'm sorry, Cheryl, I'm a little busy. I gotta get this tutu off at some point.
Okay.
I gotta make sure my zippers are still up on my boots.
Okay, sir. Yeah.
Yeah.
Okay, I'll talk to you later.
Okay, all right. Bye now.
Okay.
Thank you. We're trying.
Oh, check, check. We're trying to get dogs. We need some dogs. Who likes dogs? Anybody like dogs here?
I love dogs. Ooh, those are good dogs. Well, I feel so bad.
Interesting people.
Yes. How you doing, Justin?
I'm all right.
All right. How are you doing? Yourself? Good?
I think I can. I think
this
I can.
Is better. Wow, you've made some incredible music. It's been humbling, and also just very, just beautiful to learn and get into it. So, thank you for what you've given us. Said,
this is the head.
Sure.
Yeah. Yes, here we are, all of us. Paying tribute to... There's so many words to the song, we had to write them down, as you can see. Right? And I have to say, you know, I was talking before earlier, and that I named some names, and then there was Laurie. And before Laurie, there was only Suzanne Ciani for me. And, you know, so few women on one hand that I could look to for what they were doing in terms of music, technology, electronics, visuals, words, lyrics, that I'm so grateful that tonight all the people here who are working in the same realm. And if I'd known, I would have worn my audio tutu tonight. No one told me. So we'll have to do this again. So congratulations, Laurie. We'll be coming back to see all of the amazing things you'll be bringing to Joe's Pub. We are a lot of the alumni of Joe's Pub here. And we want to sing you to sleep at this moment. Listen to the drums beat as we sleep. Oh,
now sleep
as we speak. Listen to the drums beat as we sleep. In our sleep as we speak. Listen to the drums beat. Yeah.
say, long live music that falls on us from the skies. Thank you.
Get home safely.